Greetings, Etadies and Guardians. My name is Hyper Himes, and welcome back to Kick Your Run Kingdom, where there's nothing else that we can go ahead and talk about. We just need to head straight back at the Beasties, where we can actually start doing levels. Yeah, remember when I actually played levels instead of just watching a story go out? How the pluck do I get... World Map. Episode 3. There we go. I think we can actually go through a level this time, which that'll actually be an achievement, because last time we left off, we went through the whole spiel. Apparently, the story with Dark Account and Stormbringer happened in the middle of these two cutscenes over here, I'm assuming. Like, this one that I'm pointing to right now happened right when Dark Account was visiting a hospital full of patients when Dark Account found out about it, and that's when they finally decided to depart to... I guess Beasties, which is weird because where the pub would they even go to Beasties? Do they even have a specific location to go? I don't know, but with that being said, while doing this, I'm actually going to try to read comments from the video Blueberry Pie and Twizzly Gummy Cookies News Magic Candies. The new Magic Candies. And if you want to leave a question or comment down in the comment section below on this video, then feel free to do so. And it can't just be a random question or like a random comment. It could be a fact, something about me, something about the game, something entirely different. Doesn't even matter, because as long as we're having a fun and enjoyable time between each other, you know, between community and creator to community, that's what matters the most. So with that being said, let's just start this off from a comment from a tyrannical JJ saying, "How did you get so many gems?" I save
my gems. Like, I just barely spend. Like, I only, like, spend my gems in, like, critical, like, circumstances. Like, other than that, I just barely spend them.
Anyway, let's go ahead and ready up, where we find a Dumpling Cake Hound Alpha, Dumpling Cake Hound, and Red Bean Wolves. They aren't even cake monsters anymore. They're just straight up bean monsters. Or dumpling monsters. I don't know, I mean, they look pretty adorable, but... yeah. Let's go ahead and go through this. It's probably still gonna hit me with a cutscene immediately, but... whatever. At least we're actually making progress, finally. Hopefully our team is well enough for this. We're just doing this in normal story, just so we can experience it.
We finally made it to Beasties.
Luckily, it didn't take that long.
But isn't it strange? I've never seen the Licorice Sea so calm. I barely felt a whisper of a breeze.
To be fair, it felt like... it just has a little bit of a theory. Maybe the whole entire white flower disease washed over the Licorice Sea and infected everything there, and it just everything got destroyed there as well. And that's the only way how it could have reached the Dark Cow Kingdom, because they had to cross, and now it's affecting the cookies there. I shouldn't be smiling about that. This is kind of scary and depressing.
Right. It almost felt like someone was watching over us.
Crunchy Chip Cookie, what are you doing?
There were a bunch of licorice monsters lurking in the depths of the water, all curled up and motionless, yet their eyes remained unblinking and alert, and some of them looked right up at me!
Are you afraid? This is merely the beginning of our journey, you know.
Please, out of all the time, you please don't be afraid. We've just got here.
What? No, I'm not scared. It was just kind of creepy, that's all.
If you say so.
You laughing?
No, of course not.
That scent of raw flour in the air. The flour fog is thick in this area.
I'm just gonna say this right now. We need more Caramel Arrow and Crunchy Chip interactions. That's funny.
Won't we be infected with the pale ailment if we come in contact with the fog?
We have bubble shields. It's fine. They're definitely not gonna pop or anything.
If we were scared about that, we wouldn't have come here in the first place.
Let us share this cacao tablet. Our heads must remain clear, even in the fog.
Isn't it just one tablet? Don't we have, like, dozens of troops with us?
So bitter! What on earth bread is this made of? Not even the cacao nibs I first ate as a child were this bad!
I mean, it's probably, like, pure essence of cacao, so it's meant to be really bitter.
I suppose they made it super bitter. So that we'd come to our senses.
Don't puke.
That was good. You're all so... weak.
You gotta stop being funny, I swear.
Your Majesty, up ahead.
Well, wait, why'd you just get more fog? Wasn't it supposed to, like, not do that?
The white fog is coming right at us like a huge wave.
We will get swallowed up by the fog at this rate. Everyone, stay alert and do not lose your way.
Do not worry, Your Majesty. It's nothing my instincts can't guide me through. Just follow me. My senses are as good as the cream wolves themselves.
Crunchy Chip Cookie? Where are you?
Did they just disappear?
Crunchy Chip Cookie, answer me! He was so confident just a moment ago.
Is the fog as thick as walls?
Where is everyone? I can't see a thing.
Your Majesty! Over here!
Caramel Arrow Cookie, are you nearby?
And they're just gone too?
Caramel Arrow Cookie! Dark Cacao Warriors, answer me! It can't be. I have lost sight of everyone already. This dense fog. Cover my eyes no more!
Is this like the true terror of everyone spreading the rumors that the fog is coming? Because this is bad.
I shall blow it all away with a slash of my sword.
Well, hopefully that does all blow it away, because clearly the fog is as thick as walls. Okay, maybe I should not have joked about all those the fog is coming memes, because if that's the case, then man, we are screwed. Get these plebs all out of here. I wonder if I could swap out Caramel Arrow, or no, not Caramel Arrow, Crimson Coral, with the new defender, Cloud of Tay, which might be helpful with some later levels. I'm not sure, but I'm not sure if it would be worth it. Are they a suitable replacement? I know they're a defender. I think the only other defender that is worth replacing Caramel Arrow for is Fettuccine. And I don't know, but we got through the Continent of the Mist, which I guess before we go ahead and get deeper, I know we're only 6 minutes in, but we gotta get through a few comments. Like, for example, there's a little bit of a long one from Matwez Liswan. They say, I originally was holding back for making Twizy Gummy Kicky's Magic Candy because of Avatar Destiny, which he's really good in, because when Captain Caviar was getting the Magic Candy, the damage he was dealing was less than before, so I'm very happy that she's still good even better now, because I reached 1 billion damage with her Magic Candy. 1 billion damage is good. That's how you know they're doing the correct thing. And you know what? I'm glad that I also upgraded her magic candy as well. Coil Canyon left a comment saying, I'm begging for Eclair to get a magic candy. I would love that nerd. No, I love that nerd. I want him to be more viable. Honestly, Eclair definitely deserves a magic candy. Maybe there could be like some guild update. Maybe where they can add some new bosses. I feel like that'd be a good thing. And also, I like Sorbet Cookie. Just says, hello. Well, hello there. Just wanted to make sure I say hello to you. And Sonic Gamer left a comment saying, common question. I'm going to sound a bit biased here. I feel like I keep expressing my fatherly love towards this cookie, but I would give a magic candy to Poison Mushroom Cookie. Not sure what they'll do, but they deserve a magic candy. Honestly, I feel like you can get pretty interesting. Maybe like with a buffed poison type? I don't know exactly, but it's got to do something. Anyway, now we got to get to the next level, 3-4, which we got to get through 3-2 first, but hopefully it shouldn't take too long, because all I know is that we got to get through this fog, and hopefully the fog isn't too much of a trouble for us, because I feel like at this point, Dark Cacao kind of has to pull some weight by just slashing through this fog with the sword that they have. Because let's be honest, everyone is enveloped. Everyone's enveloped in the fog, so let's be honest, we're going to have some struggles even trying to see. I don't think we have a flashlight strong enough to pierce through all this fog. So we're going to have to like bat it away or something. I've never been in such deep fog where it actually obstructed my vision. I think the closest was like when I looked outside and it started to look like Silent Hill. I think that's how you know when the fog gets bad, but like it usually isn't that bad. Like I can still usually like see across the street, but I've never had really much of a bad. There really hasn't been much like bad fog around here. I feel like we've had more harsher storms and like storm warnings, if anything. By the way, what are these things? Smoky Cat Alpha. They're cats. They're gonna throw cats at us. After the video I just did focusing on plebbing Cloud Hattay, who was kind of like a little pet, like a little puppy. You gotta be kidding me, dude. How much more chaos do you want us to get? Because, yikes. Anyway, just get these plebs out, and then shoot the whole entire moon at them. Luckily, the bunnies don't seem to be doing much. I know we're doing this at a rather low difficulty, but I do want to get through the whole story before I do anything, which reminds me, I do need to tackle some more of the more difficult mode in Beasties, being like, well, I mean, it's just normal, but I do want to see if I can tackle some hard mode levels. It'd be a fun video. It's kind of like me trying to get through Master Mode. But that'll be safe for later. Right now, we just have to focus on the story now. I feel like before we step here, we probably do have to read a comment question of the day, because who knows how long this cutscene could be. But before we do that, let's just read all the comments that I see from Smart and Spyro, because they did leave a few. One saying, oh gosh, oh yeah, Blueberry Pie Cookie's Magic Candy is useful for the arena. I use it. Huh. I didn't know it'd be that useful for the arena, but eh, if you're right, you're right. I should try it. Another comment you left is, one time I was listening to FNF songs, it's pretty good. Well, at this day and age, who doesn't do that? Another comment you left is, at 10:32, I will say it again, I wish Cotton Cookie had a magic candy. Also, I can't wait for Caramel Arrow and Dark Chocolate to get a magic candy. Are they getting magic candies? If they are, then that'd be pretty good. I was expecting Dark Chocolate to get a magic candy soon, because that would be really nice, but hey, if they're getting one soon, then I can't wait to see it. But anyways, for a comment question of the day, let's just do something simple and kind of resemblance to this. Do you remember any days that were genuinely foggy? Like, specifically, Have you just walked out one day and, like, for some reason there was, like, this huge fog storm? I don't know exactly what you would call it, but, like, do you remember any sort of particular foggy day? Or, like, do you have any prior experiences with the fog? I'm not gonna make, like, some joke where, like, oh, common question of the day, the fog is coming, the fog is coming, the fog is coming, the fog is coming, the fog is coming. It's coming, but, like, you know, not right now. I'm not gonna let it claim me. Just, like, stay inside your house, I guess. But, like, I don't usually have some experiences. I only usually have, like, I think I had two. One was, like, you know, I think I went across to somewhere just to go ahead and, like, go to a local deli just so I can get some snacks. Because, you know, why not? But nowadays, I can't do that because I gotta watch what I eat. But I just remember crossing the street and it was foggy, but luckily, didn't have any accidents with cars. That's the thing I worried about. Like, you know, with fog going on, like, imagine that must be a nightmare for people driving. Just, like, being able to, like, hardly see. Like, I think that's even worse than, like, storm weather. And I think days that actually do get foggy are, like, more rainy days. Because I definitely do remember, some. I think more like one that was rainy, but I don't know. But anyway, I noticed how much more. How, by the way, how much. Yeah, we can only go to 3-4 before, like, the fog. Like, we can't go any more further. Like, it just gets blocked here. I don't know, but anyway, be sure to tell me down in the comment section below. Anyway, old stone steps. Okay, so I feel like Dark Akawa is going to reach a temple. And now we're facing webbed spiderlings. Great, so now we got to deal with spiders too. When does it end? When does the nightmare end? I mean, to be fair, we only just started, but still. Wait, what is this timer? A Dumpling King will be summoned once the Anguish Gauge is full. Oh, should we? So we gotta book through this level, okay. Because it goes down every second. Okay, it's a good time to kind of step up your movements. Go on through. Because I feel like that Dumpling King is gonna be a pleb to handle. Okay, here we go.
Anyone?
Hello?
Is there no one here? If you can hear me, answer! Is there really no one here?
Huh? Who the fuck is that?
Uh-huh. Fresh cookie tracks.
Oh, yeah, you found tracks, but, like, are you sure you don't hear the rustling?
Who goes there? Face my sword!
Foosh, was that a wind? They hit something.
They read the movement of my sword. What skill?
Your Majesty! It's me, Caramel Arrow.
Oh,
cookie.
Shoot, they found him.
There he is! Look, we found His Majesty!
What a relief that we found each other again.
This fog is obscuring my vision. I cannot see a thing!
I swear, if they're illusions, I'm gonna scream.
Caramel Arrow Cookie!
Yes, Your Majesty. Forever loyal to the King, it is I, Caramel Arrow Cookie.
I mean, are you sure you wouldn't say that's, like, are you okay first? I don't know if you need, like, clearance.
Crunchy Chip Cookie!
Yes, Your Majesty. I am Crunchy Chip Cookie, His Majesty's proud warrior.
I hope. Okay, I'm gonna go off a limb. Maybe this is just how they, pronounce themselves to Dark Cacao Cookie for his kingdom.
And my Dark Cacao Warriors!
Yes, Your Majesty! Glory to the Dark Cacao Kingdom!
And what of the rest?
We have lost track of the other warriors, Your Majesty. We're the only ones left.
So basically 90% of our brigade is gone.
We faced a big setback so soon.
The thick fog all but swallowed up our Dark Cacao Warriors.
They will be close by, so do not worry. We will find them once the fog settles.
Do you know how terrifying that must be, being like lost in fog? Because, like, it's not even the fact that, like, you get lost. It's the fact that you get lost and you can't see anything. And also, you're open to movement. Like, it's not like drowning or something like that where, like, you're moving, like, very much constricted. Like, you can openly move. And you'll still get lost and, like, not find a way out. That sounds awful.
There must be someone who controls this fog. We must find them.
Why don't we bring, like, a fan? And not like, a fan of, like, you know, this, but, like, I mean, just, like, a little, like, I doubt you have electric fans here, but like a little thing of paper that you can just blow the fog away. That'd be really useful. Anyway, can we blow this fog? Ooh. Steps. Oh, that's a whole kingdom. That's a whole way. Well, now we gotta get the 310. I don't know how much more we'll be able to get through in this video, but that's a whole army right there. And by a whole army, that's probably a whole ship. By the way, is that Cloud Tate Kiki right there? Is that supposed to be Cloud Tate? I don't know. But I guess before we go even deeper, we may as well read a few comments after that cutscene. Which, are we doing anything new? Noodle cocoons. They're just cocoons. They can't be that bad. Anyway, with that being said, if I can pull up the plumbing comments, random gotchatuber left a comment saying, well, I didn't pay attention to that even area. I'm going to work on that after the video ends. Yeah, probably. You'll never know how, when you don't pay attention to something until it's too late. They go hard. Okay, here we go. I do not exist. That's literally your name. The other comment saying, comment question of the day. I would love to see Herb Cookie get a magic candy. As you can see, my profile picture is Herb, so I'm kind of biased. Also, who's God? By the way, what the play was that? Wasn't in the level. Oh wait, that's the king. Hold on, wait, that's the king. That was the whole king. Wasn't 60 seconds already, was it? What? How the fuck does that work? We shall prevail. That was the king that, did the level start while the timer was already going up? Is that what happened?
Did you see that, my queen?
I saw that clearly, and I'm not your queen. Okay. What a wild thing to encounter. Luna Cupcake also left a comment saying, comment question of the day, Macaroon Cookie deserves a magic candy. I don't know why I chose Macaroon, but she needed more love from Dev Sisters. I mean, hey, Macaroon Cookie, when she was introduced in the kingdom, got a good amount of love, if I do say so myself, because I think she was actually pretty overpowered. But also, Chrisin04 left a comment saying, comment question, I want Eclair Cookie to get a magic candy, just to see if they would make him broken when he was released. Also, if you want to active Blueberry Pie's laser, put her against Cookie opponents, or in this case, her in the arena. As for stage 1030, where there is Dark Choco, Licorice Poise, Mushroom, from Congrant and Kiki are opponents. Okay, so they only be... what the fuck? They're getting boosted! Why does the king keep appearing? What is it with me doing with all these fucking kings recently? I swear, get the fuck out of here. That's just a giant cake monster. That was not as threatening as the king, I will admit, but I just like the fact that there was just a giant little cake hound right at the back.
I want to share this victory with my sisters.
Well, yeah, don't worry, it will be shared decently. But yeah, maybe I should have tested it with Blueberry Pie Cookie's magic candy more in the video, but it was just me thinking that would be used normally in, the normal levels, you know? How many more what's the status of the video? So, around 17 minutes, we'll probably stop right in front of, the four Dumpling Kings. I think that's gonna lead to a cutscene. So, let me just get through the last few comments that I see quickly. For example, Pandy67810 left a comment saying, comment question, I would love to see Rubble or Creme Brulee for a magic candy. Probably, I could see them getting magic candies. It actually seems pretty viable. They should especially give it to Rebel because they barely gave him anything when they released. The only thing they got was a cutscene, and that was literally an update that wasn't even where Rebel Kiki originated in. Oh my gosh, I swear. I think that was an anniversary update, if I'm being honest. But luckily the king isn't too hard to deal with, so that's good. Aria and Funhouse left a comment saying, comment question, I'd like Crunchy Chip to have a magic candy. Wildberry Kiki already got a magic candy, so Crunchy Chip should get one as well. Honestly, it would make sense. Wouldn't it make sense for, all the Dark Cacao Cookie, Dark Cacao Kingdom Cookies to get a magic candy? You know, Dark Choco, Caramel Arrow, Affogato, Crunchy Chip, all those cookies. Even if some are different from the others, you can't ignore the fact that they came straight from the kingdom. The last comment that I do see comes from Mona Wolf here saying, Kikuren Kingdom Gacha is too generous to me today. Even though they only gave me matcha as my only new cookie, but I'm happy because I relate to matcha a lot. I'm assuming that's because you laugh a lot. And you're always happy. And you're always devious. And you wear green. So, whatever. So, is this gonna lead to something? Because we're gonna encounter the Dumpling Kings, I guess. But, I guess it is a new level layout. I mean, they're just kind of staring at us in the back. So, I don't know. Let's just go ahead and just use the moon and just fight through them. Well, made through the level. I guess all that means is, we just entered a new setting for level. But that really doesn't mean much. Yeah, thank you, Cream Puff. Probably just one more level, or I don't know. I guess it depends. The game's- Oh, sheesh, what the pleb was that? Excuse me, what was that? The game just hard crashed. Is that the sign for me to, is that a sign from the game telling me that I should just stop? Because, by the way, what am I getting here? Oh, upgraded Kiki Castle level 13, not yet. Is that telling me to stop? Because I think I'm going to end when I do one more level, because I don't want to just stop immediately. Because I just at least want to get to the point where I'm in front of the castle at the very least. I think I usually try and strive for 10 levels, but we did get a decent amount of cutscene at the, today. So we still got, a good amount, but that was still shocking. I have no idea what the pleb happened. It was just hey, everything got destroyed.
I will end this battle!
Did it get more quiet? Why do I think it got more quiet? No, I think we're fine, but now this game is getting me paranoid. What the plug was that? I swear, game, you're really acting no better than, LD player right now. Which is why I swapped over to Google Play Games, but then again, it really didn't make much of a difference. But, still, Sometimes this I've seen this game crash, but it did like the weird slidey thing. Like it slid over to like the right, the whole game did, and it all of a sudden just crashed. This time it was just like, no, close. You will arrive at this no longer. Plumbing Mystic Flower Cookie right here is really trying to try my hardest to stop myself from actually going through this. Did a spider infestation go over this? Yeah, did we see a giant spider in this? Oh, the last boss might be a giant spider. Oh, I'm having some bad thoughts right now. Well, okay, we gotta go ahead and end this video right now, because yeah, we already spent a good amount of time. I don't think we could just skip to the whole entire game. As much as I would love to speedrun this game, I don't think you could just skip all the way to the end. I know y'all are eager, but we still have story to go through. You can't just, like, barge through the fog. You have to all walk back here. Anyway, with that being said, if you enjoyed the video, then please be sure to leave a like on it, and also share the video with your friends if you enjoy my Kick and Run content. And if you enjoy my content in general, then why not subscribe, and also hit the bell icon to be notified of whatever I do in the future. Also, down below in the descriptions, you will see links to all my social media, including a Twitter post where if it gets 10,000 likes, I can get the Kick and Run YouTube stuff for absolutely free. You will see a link to my Discord server called the Hype News Hub, a link to my merchandise where you can buy stuff to represent the channel, and lastly, a link to my Ko-fi where for just $1 a month, you can see exclusive content that you wouldn't normally see behind this Snowy YouTube channel. But above all else, I will see you entities and guardians in the next video. Hail the hype knees!